Today's lesson is on gender, gender definition and types. A gender denotes the sex of a noun. Genders are of four kinds: masculine, feminine, neutral and common. A masculine gender names males, for example, king, horse, elephant. A feminine gender denotes names of females, cow, actress, bee. Neutral genders are things which do not have life and as such have no sex: table, chair, tree, glass. It may be noted that abstract nouns are also classified as neutral genders, for example, truth, ability. Common gender may denote male or female, either or both of them. I repeat, listen to me, students. Common gender may denote male or female, either or both of them, such as architect can be a man as well as a woman, student, doctor, banker. Collective nouns are always classified as common genders, such as class, crowd. Next topic along with this is numbers. The numbers are of two kinds, singular and plural. A singular number denotes a single thing. This is especially for the junior classes. Student may take this lesson for junior classes. A singular number denotes a single thing. For example, horse, cow, flower, home, town. A plural number, on the other hand, denotes more than one thing. For example, horses, cows, flowers, homes, towns, etc. This is Principal Bhupinder's lesson on number and gender. These lessons are meant for the benefit of students. These are on my YouTube channel, Principal Bhupinder. Then there are auxiliaries and models that we'll be discussing. Verbs can be either non-finites or finites. Verbs can be either non-finites or finites. The non-finites are the infinitives, that is starting with do, I want to go. And participles are present and past. And gerunds are also called verbal nouns. The non-finites of the verb be, are, to be, to have been, being and been. Remember, infinitive normally carries two in front of it. I want to teach you people. If it is gerund, I like teaching, then it becomes a gerund. So these are the examples of special verb auxiliaries. Modal auxiliaries have may, might, can, could, must, shall, should, will, would, ought, need, dare. Used are called modal auxiliaries because they have been used to form certain moods for which English has inflected verbs. We can express such concept in mind ability. So these are special verbs auxiliaries, modal auxiliaries, and this is my lesson about number, gender and auxiliaries. Thank you, Principal Bhupinder, video blogger, YouTube channel Principal Bhupinder. Please subscribe, free for all, and please help the students, especially of classes from 4th onwards. God bless you. Principal Bhupinder, video blogger speaking.